So he has a door to the womb that we need to address. Say, Lord, open the doors. That's what happened. That was what Job was saying. Job was even believing God. Say, why should God have allowed him to live? Or to even come alive, to come as a soul? He was asking God. Number three is the door of the tabernacle. The tabernacle was what was happening before the temple. Now the temple is more of a structure. The tabernacle is more of a move, what? A makeshift thing. That was one day why you should be holding this before the temple came. Don't forget there was what David I wanted to build the temple. Remember? And God said, no, you can't build the temple for me. Your hands are filled with blood. Your son Solomon will do it. So when the tabernacle has always been there, anywhere the Israelites get to, they will build the tabernacle. Of worship. So there's a door of the tabernacle. Remember in Numbers chapter 16, verse 50. This was where the glory of the Lord dwelt. Remember in Numbers 16, the place of Korah, Yathan, and Abiram. How God dealt with them. They could not move close. They were on the other side because Moses told them, and they were saying, stand on the other side. Say, today I will know whether we are serving true God. The kind of death you experience today will never be the same again. It will become a new kind of death that has never happened before. So the door of the tabernacle is also a door that we must be what's kept open. It's a door where we can burn incense. When you say burn incense, it means where you can what for your heart unto God. So it's a door that must be opened. Number four type of door is the door of the shadow of death. I don't want that one. Door of the shadow of death or door of the sepulcher. In Job chapter 38, verse 17, he said, have the gates of death been opened unto thee? That was what the friends of Job were asking him. So what kind of situation is this? Or have thou seen the doors of the shadow of death? That's the question they were asking. What kind of cause your God and what is your problem? So sometimes we are passing through such situations. That some people just tell you, well, I'm about to imagine, remember that what's the prophecy? That someone is about to commit suicide. That person is already at the entrance of the door of shadow of death. Thank God that we're in a living church. If they are not in a living church, the person will have opened the door of the shadow of death. The pastor will not be hearing that, but Alabaga, Sister Alabaga has died. May that not be our portion of this ministry in the name of Jesus. Thank God, because God loves us. He has given us that coming out of life. Sometimes that thought will just come to your heart. You have tried, it's not working. You tried that, it's not working. People are just mocking you, and the next thing you think of is death. It means you are close to the door of the shadow of death. May that not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Such doors must be permanently what? Shut